Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be demonstrating our network flight simulator, aka Flightsim utility, which is a free open source tool. It's publicly available from our GitHub page. So here I'm just at github.com/AlphaSOC. And if I click into the repo itself, we can obviously then see, you know, the code, the README, and so on and so on. So network flight simulator, the whole point of it is to enable and empower security teams to measure the efficacy and the visibility of their SOC and SIM tooling. So it can generate C2 beacons, it can generate DGA, domain generation algorithm traffic, DNS tunneling traffic, and so on and so on. And this then enables you to ensure that your security apparatus, whether it's intrusion detection, deep packet inspection, firewalls, SIM products, orchestration, all of that good stuff, it just enables you to then ensure that those tools are actually capable and configured in such a way that they are then able to flag different malicious events that you would expect them to. So the tool itself is just a single binary. If you click into the releases section here in GitHub, top right, you'll see that we have pre-built versions for Windows, Linux, and Mac OS here with the Darwin release. I'm on my Mac today, so I'll just pull down the Mac version, and let me just move over into a terminal window. And then into downloads. And the first thing we want to do is mark the binary as executable so we can actually then use it from the command line. So chmod a plus x flightsim. And then if I just run the tool in this way with no arguments, it will obviously just provide the usage and some very high level information. If I click back into the documentation, the thing to mention here is that the tool itself ships with a number of modules. So here we have the list of 8 modules that are available with the utility today. And these modules can then generate and synthesize C2 traffic either as DNS requests, direct IP connections out to known C2 destinations. It can synthesize domain generation algorithm traffic. It can test for DNS hijacking support within an environment. Perform TCP port scanning, check for connectivity out to known sinkholes. So sinkhole destinations, run by Microsoft, Kaspersky, Symantec. We at AlphaSOC we track and understand that infrastructure. So within this tool, we can then test for connectivity out to sinkholes and then see whether SIM products in particular and other apparatus flags those types of connections. We can emulate spam bot traffic where we try and establish a lot of connections out to mail servers. And then finally in here we have DNS tunneling synthesis as well, where we're putting together kind of encoded requests out to sandbox.alphasoc.xyz, which is then indicative of DNS tunneling traffic. So with the tool itself, you can either run it with no arguments, so just using Flightsim here with the run command. This will just invoke all 8 of the modules and just run them one after the next. Or you can run particular modules one at a time. So here we're just executing the C2 DNS module, and it then tells us, okay, this is the network interface that I'm using to generate this traffic. I'm preparing a random sample of current domains, and then connecting out to each of them. So these are C2, legitimate C2 destinations that have come down from the cybercrime tracker, which is just an open tracker that we use within the tool here to pull down like a live list of C2s. And you'll see that if I rerun the test, because of the way it randomizes, it's going to pick a different batch of C2s each time. And each of these we'd expect to then be flagged within your SIM. Your SIM should be running in such a way that it understands that VIP filenet.uni.me is a C2 destination. And you can obviously correlate and check for this particular IP address, these timestamps, and these events within your sim to ensure that you do have visibility. If I run the next module, so just C2IP, this is doing a very similar thing, but performing just straight IP connections out to destinations on particular IPv6 and IPv4 services. And again, we'd expect these to show up in your tooling if it's configured correctly and able to flag, you know, C2 traffic. I won't go through all of them, and I guess I will finish up showing the port scan module, and then we'll do some DNS tunneling. So the port scan module just generates a random sample of internal, you know, RFC 1918 private addresses, and then once it has the list, it then performs scanning, port scanning of those, just regular, you know, vanilla TCP port scanning. And then finally, let's do the tunnel testing. So this is encoding and generating, you know, long DNS labels and routing them out to sandbox.alphasoc.xyz, which is then indicative of what you would see if somebody was using Cobalt Strike or Iodine or any of these DNS tunneling tools to then exfiltrate data out via DNS. And that pretty much is what I wanted to show you guys today. So I hope that that's been useful. If you do have any questions, obviously, feel free to reach out to us, you know, support@alphasoc.com. Look us up on Twitter. And then finally, we've got a lot of other videos coming. So if you do subscribe using the red button bottom right here in YouTube, we'd appreciate that as well. All right. Thanks a lot. Bye.